Welcome, fans, to the Western Fair Sports Center for tonight's GOJHL game between the London Nationals and Chatham Maroon. I'm your host, Sophie Bernier, and tonight's story of the game, brought to you by Source for Sports, is Home Stretch. We are now officially more than halfway through the season, although the unofficial second half of the season is always considered to start right after the holiday break. The Nationals have 18 games remaining and are currently tied for second with LaSalle and sit just 1 point back from the first place St. Mary's. So we're in for quite an exciting second half of the season. I'll send you up now to Kyle and Jeremy for more.
Thanks, Sophie. And yes, the GOJHL trade deadline was today, and we made a trade ourselves. Kyle Gosling not in the lineup tonight, so we acquired Kyle Brebner in alongside me tonight. And Kyle, heading into tonight's game, like Sophie mentioned, the Nationals 1 point back of first place in the Western Conference. It's been that everlasting battle so far this season where the Nationals have been able to flip-flop between first, second, and third this season.
Yeah, at this point in the season, it's always important, and tonight's game no different. As Sophie mentioned, 1 point back of first place, so first place is on the line tonight for the London Nationals.
Yes, and last week the Nationals had three games here. Last Wednesday we were not here, but the Nationals were, and they got an overtime win over the Lincolns. And then they had a rare Saturday home game, Kyle, where they fell to LaSalle, and then they go down on the following Sunday and get the victory there. So going 2-1 during that three-game stretch, certainly key to be able to keep up with the LaSalle Vipers.
Yeah, always important as it's always tight in this Western Conference here in the GOJHL, and super important to stick with your teams right around you.
Yes, and looking at the Nationals lineup tonight, you see Blake Arrowsmith up on that top line with Riley Wood and Lucas Chard. This London lineup is starting to find their groove now. Like Sophie mentioned, we're at the unofficial midway point of the season, so you're seeing this Nationals team now solidified a little bit. So again, this team looking to get some offense going here. What do you like to see out of that lineup here tonight?
As you mentioned, they're just starting to find their footing. Maybe just play with a little more sense urgency here, but just solid hockey just so they can continue their momentum towards the playoff here.
Yeah, so we'll take a look at the starting goaltenders in for tonight's game. Hayden Sabourin getting the start for the Nationals. Has been stellar all season long for this Nationals group. Again, a 905 save percentage and 2.77 goals against. And then you can go down the 200 feet of ice to the other side for the Maroons. It is Tommy O'Donnell for the Maroons. He's had a good start as well for the Maroons.
Yeah, see there, O'Donnell, 7-1-1, 3-2-4 GA, 901 save with first career shutout last weekend.
And with that, we'll send it down to ice level for our opening ceremonies.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Stand on guard for thee.
And yes, so the Nationals 1 point back as we're taking a look at head coach of the Chatham Maroons there, Richard Santos. He's got this team going in the right direction now. Like we mentioned, only 5 points back of the Nationals currently. They sit in third while the Maroons sit in fifth place. They currently trail the Strathroy Rockets, so the top five in the Western Conference is slowly starting to pile up and create that logjam. And then on the other side, it is Brian McAllister, just his fourth game behind the bench here tonight for the Nationals. Again, we last saw when we were back here on the 20th of December, he was just making his Nationals head coaching debut. And so far, he's gotten off on the right foot, only losing one game so far. Top line out for the Nationals, Riley Wood, Lucas Chart, and Blake Arrowsmith out there as well as the puck is dropped and we are underway here on Archon Agate. It's Nationals hockey here on Rogers TV. Puck is dumped in by Brandon Scott. O'Donnell will just rim it around the corner and now the Maroons will send their breakout. A bit of a fan shot as Wood just sends that right back in towards O'Donnell. And now Chatham will regroup. Couple Nationals trying to steal the puck there, but it's turned over, and now with it here is Cleary. Cleary loses it to Riley Wood. Now the Nationals come in, 2-on-3. Here comes a chance for Arrowsmith, drops it back. Trying to feed Chard, not able to do so, but Chard does regain possession. Chard comes over the line, cuts towards the middle of the ice. Here's Arrowsmith, shoots, and a glove save made by O'Donnell. And a good one at that here early on, just 40 seconds into this game, Kyle.
Yeah, London's tested Chatham here early. O'Donnell's had to be sharp here.
That's it, so a faceoff will be to O'Donnell's left. Now the second line out for the Nationals, LePain, Palmer, and Milne. We've seen this line as of late starting to really produce, especially with LePain and Palmer starting to get that chemistry going. Faceoff one to P.J. Fagan, shot right on, and that goes right into the breadbasket of Tommy O'Donnell. And P.J. Fagan, another guy as well, he's had a couple of good games recently. He got the call up to the London Knights a few games ago and really did well. They win the draw, get it right back to Fagan. He's unable to get the shot away, and now controlling the puck here is Burke. Burke sends this over to Colton Henderson. He's got 9 points on the campaign for Chatham. He strips Fagan of the puck, looks in the slot. That one's shot, pad save. And now here's Milne. Milne over to Palmer. London trying to get some numbers. Here's LePain. He'll shoot, and that's again right into the breadbasket there of Tommy O'Donnell. So far in this game, Kyle, we're seeing a bit of fast pace, a little bit sloppy to start, but nonetheless, London's trying to possess the puck.
Yeah, I've also noticed, too, London's been really aggressive on the forecheck here early.
And so now the faceoff will be to the right of O'Donnell. O'Donnell's got a 901 save percentage and a 3.24 goals against average. Chatham breaks this one up as here's Ellison. That one's turned over there by Fagan. Fagan tries to send this one up ice. And now back to get it, Logan Pacerock. He sends this into the slot. Chance for Chatham. Early shot right on. That misses wide. Ellison. Down there battling two Nationals, two Maroons down in the corner. Winning that puck there is Kale Morante. Comes off the glass, bounces off, and there's Josh Harding, newly acquired. And that puck will bounce up and out of play, and so a faceoff will come inside the neutral zone.
Take a look at this turnover here. Coach is always stressed to take care of the puck. Pacerock does not do that there. Turnover right into the middle of the ice, but luckily for Sabourin, the puck was just wide.
Yeah, you can see Pacerock didn't see the Chatham player coming up the middle of the ice, and that created that turnover, something that the Nationals really want to try to clean up so far this season. Face off one, here's Fisher. That one's turned right back over to the Maroons. And now with the puck here is Brody Gillis, the former National. He got himself on the board with a couple of points the last time these two teams played here at the Western Fair Sports Center. Fisher, he's gonna take an offensive rush here. He's gonna skate in. Here's the shot. Oh, that just missed wide as O'Donnell did not see that clearly, and now that gets cleared out, and now a foot race. Here's Atlee Rogers. Rogers dumps it to Fisher, trying to feed off and Gouvernement. That's turned over. Trying to go in and out. Here's a shot on him, and they score! Jacob Kluche gets his sixth goal of the season, and only 2.5 minutes into this contest, Chatham has a 1-0 lead.
And Jeremy, we said it earlier, limit the mistakes. It looks like another one right here. As London loses the puck right in the middle of the ice, Kluche right around his defender and over Scott and over Sabourin for the goal to open the scoring here in London.
Yeah, it's just hard work there by Kluche, having Michael Kopchak all over him and just able to get a beauty backhand up over the top. Nationals looking to respond, and they do! They score! Chatham strikes first, London responds. And on the board is the guy you want to get going most, the leading point scorer for the Nationals, and Lucas Chard.
An excellent response here by the Nationals. face-off win, they break into the... Take a look at this here. Face-off win, they break into the zone. Three-man passing play. Wood delays just long enough for Chart to have a wide-open opportunity. And we're all knotted up.
Yeah, just a smart play there by Lucas Chart. He could have got that puck in the middle of the ice. He let Wood receive it, and then Wood drops it right back to Chart into the slot. And just like that, only 3 minutes in, two goals already. Aerosmith trying to get this one up to the blue line. There's Michael Downey. He loses it. And now Wood's back there to receive it. Brandon Scott to Matthew Downey. Wood. Wood showing patience, trying to find Aerosmith. Bounces into the slot. And there to grab that, there is O'Donnell, and he'll hang on. So far, we're not even halfway through, and both teams are showcasing their speed, and they're trying to use the full size of the ice so far in this contest. Face off won by the Maroons, winning the draw. Back there was Cleary. Goes back to the line, Fagan trying to feed over to Paceroth, but Paceroth had left the zone. And now Chatham will regroup on their breakout. And all the way down, and it'll not go for icing as it was tipped by Fagan. Fagan trying to backhand clear. This one's going to come towards the side of the net. Loose out in front. And it'll squirt out back to the point for Brendan McKay. Harding sends it up ice, and now Fagan trying to get that up ice, turned over by Burke, but now Fagan has it once again. And he's just going to carry this into the offensive zone. Fagan taken down on the play. The arms are staying down. Chatham going to send this one up high. There to Colton Henderson. Henderson in and out on Milne, tries to go in and out and makes a nice little play. Puck's coming cross ice, Fagan one man back. And great job with the stick to get that puck and turn it over for the Nationals quickly with Talon Palmer. Palmer sends this one in deep. He tries to get the puck there first, but he's in a battle with Fortier Smith. Puck comes out the ice, here's Fluchier. Passes this one over, 4-on-2 here for the Maroons, trying to take advantage of the Nationals changing, but the Nationals do a good job of just taking the opportunity away. LeBlanc, he comes in. Centering feed doesn't work. It'll go back to the point to Kopchuk. LeBlanc tries to get a stick on it, but now Fortier Smith going to battle down low with Hirsch. Elson just swings this one over, and the Maroons just send it in deep, and Hayden Sabrin goes back to retrieve. Turns over, Hanson in the slot, they score! Turnover by Hayden Sabourin. And I don't like saying this, Kyle, but I'm gonna say it. If you're a goaltender, your job's to tend the goal. And that's a mistake by the Nationals netminder, and Brody Gillis, the former National, gets on the board.
Yes, it is, Jeremy, you mentioned it. That might be one where Sabourin's gonna look around and maybe just leave that puck for his defenseman, because that was right on the stick of Brody Gillis.
Yeah, just a bad break there for Sabourin, not reading where the Chatham players were, and it goes into the back of the net. Just the third shot on the net for the Maroons and two quick goals. Downey sends this around the glass and it'll go up and out of play, so the faceoff will just stay inside to the right of Hayden Sabourin.
Going to take a look at that last goal here from a different angle. You see here, nobody really around Sabourin. He could have just dumped that puck off, but instead tries to go around the boards, and it ended up on the stick of Gillis.
Face off one here by the Maroons. Shot right through. That's a good pad save made by Sabourin, and he's fighting through some traffic. Another shot right on, and that's a save. Penalty is going to be coming up here to the Nationals. McGuire. He goes down low. He's looking for a pass option. Still controls. Cuts, tries to go towards the middle of the ice. Still has control. Stops it off to Elson. Elson will send it down low where the Nationals are going to try to get there first. And they still won't. No whistle yet. And now the whistle comes. And our first penalty of the game is going to be an interference call. And this one is going to go to the Nationals and Matthew Downey.
Yes, it is. Downey was just kind of wrestling around wrestling with his man around the net. No one was even close to the puck. Just kind of took him down. Ref's going to call that one every time.
So, you know, Chatham will go to the power play. But just like the Nationals, they both have struggled on their power play. Chatham currently ranked 7th in the Western Conference with a 14.1% efficiency. They do win the draw, but it does clear the blue line. And now Brody Gillis. Gillis already has a goal in this contest off the mistake of Hayden Sabrin. Matheson. He'll go down low with it. Trying to poke that away is Fisher. Centering feed, that one will go to Chart. And now out comes the Nationals, and here's Milne. Milne's got Lucas Chart with him. He'll just dump it off to Chart. Chart, the one National down low, blows a tire. And now Chatham will get their set up. Cleary. Comes in and out, one man to beat, and Fagan drops it off. Matheson sends it high up into the slot. Here's Bacik. That shot stopped. Rebound right to Gillis' shot. That's high up into the air. And Logan Paceroff will bat it down and just feed it to Lucas Chard. And he'll send it down the length of the ice. 50 seconds to go in the Chatham power play. Bacik, the captain for this Chatham squad. Sends it over here to Matheson. Matheson will just send that one in deep. Hayden Sabring out, he's gonna have to be quick on this one, does a better job on that clear, and it'll go all the way down the length of the ice. Graydon Jones. Second unit's out here on the ice, now Talon Palmer out there to penalty kill and almost gets the turnover, and he's gonna create some excellent pressure here and not allow the Maroons to get their setup as now they'll enter the neutral zone. Low centering feed, Fisher takes that one away. Goes back to the point. Now here to Burke. Burke waits for the traffic tip, they score off the deflection! Colton Henderson has his stick on the ice, right place, right time, beats Sabre in five hole. And a power play goal with just 1 second left on it. And just like that, Chatham now has a two goal lead.
You're always going to tell you keep your stick on the ice. Here's example A of why you do that. Henderson with a stick in the perfect spot for that power play opportunity. And that's another power play goal given up by the Nationals. And that's been an issue this year.
Yes, it's been a season-long issue, just their special teams overall. But now a chance here for the Nationals, potentially 2-on-1. Gouvermont shoots that one just high over the top of the net. Has a good active stick there by Owen Kopp to put that one up and out of play.
Yeah, you mentioned special teams as a whole an issue. London's power play only 6 in the West, and the penalty kill also 6 at just 79%.
Yeah, that's something that they want to improve here in the second half of the season. Harding just sends this one over to his partner in Kalp. And Chatham will send this one in deep. So far, 8 shots on net for the Maroons, and they found the back of the net 3 times. And now Mount London trying to get a response here. Rogers, he's trying to feed Gouvermont, unable to do so. We are going to see a penalty coming up, and this time it's going to go to the Maroons, and it's likely going to be a hook. No, it'll be tripping on the play, so London has their first power play coming up.
Yeah, take a look here. London is trying to make a play through the neutral ice, and he gets his stick right in the midsection and goes down. Yeah. Textbook tripping penalty right there.
Yeah, hooking, tripping, whatever it is, it's the call. And now London gets himself set up. Milne. Downey, he'll take the one-time shot. That's stopped by O'Donnell. Bit of a different look here. No Lucas Chard, he is out on the ice, and now he's got the puck. Chard, Palmer, chance shot. That's gloved down by O'Donnell. As just good side-to-side movement there by O'Donnell takes away that good scoring chance.
Yes, it does, but that was really nice puck movement on that power play for the Nationals. Keep doing that, they'll get more, the opportunities will come and the pucks will go in the net.
Chard in to take the draw, he wins it back to Downey. Chard kind of playing more of a one-time option on the side, and Michael Downey quarterback, but now Chard moves to the middle of the ice. Looking for a chance out in front, that one will get cleared down the ice. Saverin's gonna go all the way out to come and play it. And he'll shoot it around to where Lucas Chard is off here along the sidewall. Chard takes a hit to Elson. Elson will try to send it in deep, but Downey does get control, and now Chard. Chard works his way down low, trying to get the Nationals into their setup, but a good stick there by the Maroons, and they'll send it down the length of the ice. Saverin again, having to spin fire that puck to Fisher, and now the second unit out for the Nationals. Fisher behind his own net. Drops it to PJ Fagan. Fagan turning on the speed. Looks to try to shoot, doesn't have an option, drops it to Fisher. Fisher sends it over to Scott. Interesting look, they've got three defense out here on this second power play unit. Normally not something that we see. Here's Fagan. Fagan has the chance to shoot, and he does. Glove stop, and it'll go over to Aerosmith. Scott, that's a wrister. That just misses wide. 5 seconds left in the power play. Fisher just dumps this off to Fagan. Fagan, again, looking for a pass option. Gets Rogers, trying to feed Fagan in the slot, unable to do so. Bouncing puck goes up and over the top of the net. And now Atlee Rogers just sends this down low to Blake Aerosmith. Back up to Fagan. Fisher, that one shoots wide. Scott sends this one down low, trying to clear it. There was McGuire. And now a good active stick, and now we'll go back to the point to Fisher. Fisher just sends this one back down low. The Nationals will try to get a cycle going here with 9 minutes to go here in this first period. 3-1 is your score. Fisher works his way down low, trying to get into the slot to Atlee Rogers, unsuccessful, but Fisher does get the puck back. Good cycle game here by the Nationals, hemming this Chatham group in. Now London's trying to get a change going, and they'll get Hershut on the ice, as well as LeBlanc. Good keep in by Pace Rock. Here's Kopchak. He'll shoot that one in, a glove save made by O'Donnell. As our first period is brought to you by Great White Wealth Management. And so Tommy O'Donnell getting some work in, is now shot to now 8-8.
Yeah, that was a really good stretch there for London, just putting the pressure on Chatham.
Face off won cleanly there by the Maroons. And it'll exit the zone. Kopchak and Chipman battling for it, but now Kalp has the puck. Tried to send that one in deep, there was Burke, but he's unable to do so, but the puck works its way behind the London net. And now Henderson, he's got a goal in here tonight, one of the three Chatham goals so far in this opening period. Kalp, nice pass, sends it over Henderson, good stick, and Kopchak's gonna get the gate. And hooking's likely gonna be the call here, as he just kept on stick checking Henderson and ends up taking a penalty.
Yeah, Jeremy, he's not a fan of that call, but that's just hard work by the Chatham here. Watch this. Just working the puck and making Kopchak basically take a penalty there.
Yeah, so Chatham will go to work here for the second time here in tonight's contest. They scored with 1 second left in their earlier power play. See if they can go 2-for-2 here. And down behind the net, Lucas Chard has control. And he'll send it down to Tommy O'Donnell. O'Donnell just leaves it there, and now Chatham will go the other way. Here's Brody Gillis. He's spent a number of games here for the Nationals before being dealt to Chatham, and a good acquisition for this Maroons team. Now Cleary tries to feed Gillis at the blue line, but Gillis was more towards the middle of the ice. And so now Chatham will regroup, and here's Bacik, the captain. Over to Gillis. Gillis gains the zone entry. He's gonna beat Brandon Scott to the puck and keep the puck moving. Then back and now a foot races. Here's a chance for Milne. Milne shorthanded, has Chart, drops the Chart. Chart shoots, that's blocked. And now Chatham will come back the other way, trying to go with numbers as they're gonna make a change. Cloutier, he shoots, that one just goes wide. Fagan just ends up playing it off the boards and that goes right back onto Cloutier's stick. Back to the point here for Jones. Jones, Cloutier not able to get the shot away and that one is cleared down the ice by PJ Fagan. Braden Jones, he's got 13 points on the season so far. And he'll dish the puck off as, again, changes being made. Bounces off the linesman and now Morante's got it. And now Braden Burke. Here's Henderson. Henderson waits, shows good patience, tries to bank that one off the back of the net, trying to feed his man in front of Morante, but he's unable to do so. Penalty expired, Nationals kill it off. Palmer over to Kopchak. He's got LePain with him. Here's LePain, he's gonna try to get a shot away. He does, and a good stop made there as Kopchak kind of got into the area of O'Donnell. Now a chance here, maybe a France 2-on-0. Here's Palmer. Palmer, LePain tries to elevate it, and that just crashes hard as Jackson, Fortier-Smith all alone there to take that away as a 2-on-0 for the Nationals, unable to get on the score sheet there.
Yeah, unable to get on the score sheet, but this is, I like the hustle here from LePain. Causes the turnover, kind of just throws a puck to the middle, starts the 2-on-0 with Palmer, but just misses on the tap-in.
And a very good read there by O'Donnell, recognizing on that play that Palmer was going to pass. And in that situation, he might have been better off to try to get a shot away, knowing that O'Donnell's going to cheat towards that one side. The officials put the net back on. Chatham wins the draw, and they'll just shoot this one off the glass and out. And Bouvermont just sends this one back in. Fourth line out here for the Nationals. Puck inside of London's zone. Here's Atlee Rogers. He loses it. But a good pickup by Paceroth, but he loses it off a stick. And now here's Kopchak. Sends this up, and this will hit the meshing. So the faceoff is going to stay inside of London territory. And so far in this game, Kyle, we haven't quite seen London be able to get those scoring opportunities. Besides the 2-on-0 and the early goal by Lucas Chard, London hasn't really had their passing game going.
No, Chatham's done a really good job of taking the passing lanes away from the Nationals here.
Another faceoff win by the Maroons. Turned over, now another chance here, and that one will just go off the stick of Colton Chipman all the way down. And he'll try to make a centering feed, and it'll go into the corner to LeBlanc. Just missed again over Chipman's stick, and in to get it there is Bacik, the captain. LeBlanc's going to try to get there first before Chase Smith gets control. Sent back again, Chatham trying to get a breakout going. They'll make a long home run stretch pass, and that is just going to be offside on the play there as the Maroons just trying to make that home run pass work. So faceoff will come all the way down inside to the left of O'Donnell. 4:27 to go here in this opening period. Chatham leading 3-1. Here's Jeremy Hirsch. He loses the puck, and now Chatham again coming out here with speed. And with it is Matheson, but he's just also offside. As part of me, that was Elson, and he was trying to break in with Edwards, but Edwards just a stride offside on the play. Top line back out here for the Nationals. Chart trying to win the draw. It'll go into a couple of skates and Chart gets control. Chart trying to go in and out on his defender there. He does gain control and now Aerosmith will go into the corner to get it. Aerosmith gonna try to get his stick in there, trying to take it away from Morante. Bouncing puck and Fisher will send it up ice. And this one's going to get sent all the way down, and Chatham will have iced the puck. With a few tired defenders out there, they had started to make a bit of a change. And so a bit of an opportunity here for London's top line to try to take advantage of a couple of tired Maroon players. Chard, he wins the draw. He looks towards Fagan, elects to keep it, and he'll just get the cycle game going. Centering feed over to Aerosmith, and now Fagan. Up down low now to Matheson. They'll skate up ice, trying to get themselves going offensively as well. Three goals for this Chatham team so far in this opening 20 minutes. And McGuire just sends it in deep to Sadrin. Fagan dumps it off to Aerosmith. Aerosmith almost lost the puck on the turnover. Now the Nationals have numbers the other way. Here's Chard, cuts in, shoots, that one goes up and into the netting. And out of play.
And we mentioned earlier, London not getting a lot of scoring opportunities. Another good example there. Chatham just taking away anything, just getting sticks on pucks, taking away opportunities.
And that's what you want to have if you're a defensive team like the Chatham Maroons. Keep those sticks into the active passing lanes and take away any opportunity that this high-scoring London offense can have. Matheson just flips this puck into the neutral zone, and Kopchop's going to take it. Feeds this one over to Mill. Mill's trying to get a shot away. Now Paceroth shoots. That goes loose into the slot. Chatham gets control, and they have an open man here with some speed, trying to cut towards the middle of the ice. There's a shot. That one's blocked by Kopchuk, and now the Nationals will try to come the other way. Mill in a little pain. Nice little pass. He's got Palmer streaking down the other side. Here comes a chance for the Nationals shot. And that actually is a good active stick once again, as they're not able to get a shot away. Downey sends it to Palmer. Palmer sends it out in front. Loose puck behind the net. Mill. Mill trying to wrap it around, and there's Gillis, who has the puck and will shoot it up off the glass. And now Chatham's going to try to get fresh forwards out. Here's Downey trying to make a backhand pass.
Off, off, off! Good!
Nationals trying to make one too many fancy passes here. Need to try to simplify their game. LePayne, LeBlanc, he shoots that one, just misses wide. Downey, he keeps it alive. Sends it cross ice. Here's Scott. Scott with the shot. That one's stopped by O'Donnell. Jacob Gluce gets the long stretch pass. Waits for his forward group to get up ice. They do, and he'll carry it in with some speed. Cuts towards the middle of the ice, trying to get past a couple of Nationals. And now they're in a puck battle there with Downey, and Gluce does a great job of winning it. And now sending it back to Bacek. Bacek at the point. He shoots. That's deflected just wide. Another centering feed. That hits the side of the net. Now for Jay Smith, he'll shoot, deflection out in front, lots of traffic in front of Sabrin. And now London will try to push the puck the other way. Here's Hirsch with Chipman. Chipman waiting to try to find an option, and here's Hirsch. Hirsch had a pretty cool opportunity last night where he got to play with other 05 born players, as that one gets onto the net and stopped there by O'Donnell. And he'll hang on again.
You mentioned it, Jeremy. Active sticks by the Maroons all night long. Here's another example. As at the last second, gets a stick on it, and he cannot hit the net.
And again, London with a top line out. Going back to Hirsch, he got an opportunity to play part of a GOJHL All-Star type of team with other 05 born players in a game against the Ridley College Tigers, where the GOJHL actually won in the shootout. And Ridley College, actually, Colton Chipman of the Nationals played there in 2019-20. Here's a chance for the Nationals, back to Fagan. Fagan shoots off the crossbar! Oh, Fagan had daylight upstairs, and he finds the red. Here's Chard, he shoots, that one's stopped again. Clearing attempt, goes to the line, and it will leave the zone. Nationals have to wait. And now Chatham controls. Here's Aerosmith. Aerosmith with not much time shoots, and that one stopped by O'Donnell. And one look here at this Fagan crossbar chance.
Yeah, this is really nice passing play by the Nationals. Just slow it down a little bit, enough to find a lane to get a shot out. And Fagan had the top of the net open, but he was a little high and hit the crossbar.
Yeah, close call for the Nationals late. 3-1 your score. 20 minutes down, 40 minutes to go. You're watching Archon Aggregates Nationals Hockey here on Rogers TV. First intermission's coming up.
Welcome back. I'm joined with Chatham Maroon forward Jacob Coche. Now, Jacob, you played for the Pittsburgh Penguins AAA team last season. What did you like about living and playing in Pittsburgh?
Yeah, it was an unreal experience. I was there with two of my best friends, so I got to build it with one of them. It was awesome. A lot of ice time, a lot of games, a lot of practices. I feel like it made me so much better.
You started this season in the OHL with the Saginaw Spirit. What was that experience like for you?
Yeah, it's incredible. OHL is my dream, right? So ever since I was a kid, I've been dreaming of playing there. So it's just awesome.
What are some personal goals you have for yourself for this new year?
I don't know, just be the best player I can be, help my team win games, do what I gotta do, right?
Now your team's up early in this game. There's 40 minutes remaining. What are you and your teammates looking to do to stay ahead in tonight's competition?
Yeah, I think consistency. I think we've been struggling with that recently. So I think if we stay consistent, put up a few more, I think we win this game.
Thank you so much, Jacob. We'll be right back with some more London Nationals hockey here on Rogers TV after this.
Watch, play, and win every Monday night at 8 p.m. with Optimus TV Bingo on Rogers TV. Cards are available at multiple London locations and are good for all three games. Weekly jackpots total $3,000. Back here at the first intermission, Chatham Maroons lead this game 3-1. And so far in this game, Kyle, we were talking about it off air, how the Nationals have just not been able to get those scoring opportunities where the Chatham Maroons are finding the London mistakes.
Yeah, they are. London's made a couple of mistakes in that first period, and Chatham capitalized on them. Two of their three goals were direct results from London mistakes.
Yeah, and we'll take a look at the goals in that first period. Again, Cluche just being able to dominate that puck and a nice solid backhander up over the top of Hayden Sabrin to get themselves going here just 2 minutes in. And then the Nationals respond themselves. Wood back to start. We have seen that night in and night out here at the Western Fair Sports Center. And then here's the turnover by Sabrin. He tried to feed that one off to Fisher, but Fisher just did not pick up that puck. And then Brody Gillis just able to get that shot towards the net and get himself on the board. And then this was laid on the power play. Burke to Henderson down low for that nice little tip to late. There, as you can see, Cluche, his sixth, Chard getting his 13th here on the campaign. And shot 16-9 in favor of the Nationals. But again, it just goes back to the turnovers that the Nationals have been having.
Yeah, couple. It doesn't look like they should be, it looks like they should be dominating, but a couple mistakes here and there. Your opponent capitalizes, and you're down 3-1 before you know it.
And with those 16 shots, 15 saved by Tommy O'Donnell. We'll take a look at some of his work so far in this opening 20 minutes. O'Donnell is very strong positionally. A lot of the shots are going right into the middle of his chest.
Yeah, right in the middle of the chest. Not giving London a whole lot to square up on the net and shoot at.
Yeah, just a lot of hard work there by O'Donnell. Not much traffic in front of him, but again, when we take a look at the standings, it's now at the official, unofficial midway mark here of this second half of the regular season. Nationals, again, currently sitting 1 point back of first place. Currently, that belongs to the St. Mary's Lincolns, as you can see it here on your screen. Just from 1-5, only 6 points separates first from fifth. At the beginning of the season, it was the Devil's Triangle at the top with St. Mary's, LaSalle, and London, but now you can't count out their Rockets, and you can't count out the Maroons either.
No, you can't. Five teams within 6 points, that's always nice to see. Parity in the league is always a good thing, and you see there, any one of those five teams has a shot here in these last 18 games.
Yes, and normally what we've seen in years past when the Leamington Flyers were in this conference, we normally had seen themselves, the Nationals, and sometimes this Chatham Maroons team run away and have it kind of be a three-horse race. But again, at this halfway point, we're seeing not it being three, we're seeing five teams so far. So that's exciting to see if you're a GOJHL fan, especially in the Western Conference.
Yeah, for sure. Parity is always going to be a good thing in sports.
Yes, 20 minutes down, 40 minutes to go. We'll take a break and we will have the second period of action coming up. You are watching Archon Aggregates Nationals Hockey here on Rogers TV.
leading St. Mary's with a score 2-1 after one.
Our next contest here on Oricon Aggregates Nationals Hockey is next Wednesday, and look who's in town. It is LaSalle Vipers. They will be here next Wednesday here at 7 p.m. right here on Rogers TV, and that will be an exciting matchup once again, as currently on the out-of-town scoreboard, the LaSalle Vipers lead the St. Mary's Lincolns 2-1 after 20 minutes in their contest. So if LaSalle wins, they will go back up into first place. And so now for the Nationals, they need to turn themselves around here with the next 40 minutes here, and it starts with that netminder in Hayden Sabrin.
Yeah, Sabrin just needs to be a little sharper and help mitigate some of the mistakes that the Nationals do continue to make them.
Yes, and we've seen this Nationals team come back in the past. We know about their high-scoring offense. For the Maroons, they want to try to continue their defensive strategy of just keeping the sticks in the passing lanes and not allowing the Nationals to create those off the rush chances. So we're just about underway here for period number two. GOJHL trade deadline was today, and the deadline actually just passed at 7 o'clock, right as the puck dropped. So teams can no longer make any moves. And so now the Maroons are waiting for their one player to come back. A little late coming on to the ice. As we're ready to go, puck is dropped. And period number two started. Chatham leading 3-1. So far over the Nationals, and here's Milne. Sends this one over to Downey. Downey comes in with some speed, shot, that one's blocked. And now back the other way comes Elson. Elson loses it as now Milne gathers. Creates some space and now comes in with some speed. Over to Palmer. Palmer trying to feed LePain, doesn't get to him. And now he's got some shooting room, doesn't save, rebound loose. It'll go up to Palmer, and he'll just send it back down to LePain and try to get the cycle going. Puck bounces off a couple of skates, and Lennon will just send this one back in. And back there is Downey, and he'll just send it back towards O'Donnell as London makes changes. Again, stretch pass there to Cleary, as Cleary will just send that one in deep. It's rimmed around to Brandon Scott. lands on the stick there of Wood, and he stretches over to Lucas Chard. He's unable to catch that loose puck, but Logan Pacerock steps up. Riley Wood, he's in a bit of a battle down there, as well as here's Pacerock. Tried to find Arrowsmith. Pacerock just sends it back towards the net, and now here's the captain, Batchick. Batchick sends this one over to Braden Burke. Sends it down low to Colton Henderson. Puck controlled now by the Nationals as they will try to get their breakout game going, as here's Pace Roth, just sends it over to Kopchak. Nice little touch pass by Wood, and now Chard. Chard got two defenders on him. Here's Wood, backhand feed, no one home, as he thought Arrowsmith would be on the wide side. As the puck now goes all the way down the ice, and Saverin comes out to play the puck. Icing was potentially going to be called, but Saverin comes out to play it. So the Nationals will try to get a breakout going. Pacerock just turns that one over to his opposite defense. And now Chatham has a chance here, 3-on-1. Burke, Wade's passes across and just goes off the stick of Matheson. Matheson takes a hit, but regained control. He sees a man cross ice, he's gonna hold. Wade, shot, fanned on, Kopchak, good stick. Stepping up here is Jones. Jones in the corner, it goes off the glass, and now a foot race now, and here's Hirsch. Hirsch, 2-on-1 with LeBlanc. Here is Hirsch, over to LeBlanc, and he just misses it behind him. London trying to get some offense going, but just their pass is not hard enough. Here's Fagan, that's a one-time shot, that one's blocked. Trying to get it over to Hirsch, and now Chatham will try to go the other way with their speed. Fisher trying to get there first. Puck does not clear the zone, turned over to Cloutier. Rimmed around down low, and now here's Morante. And it'll go right towards the net, and Hayden Saverin gets the glove down.
No team really showing no team really having an advantage here in the second period so far. Both teams really using their speed to try and generate some chances.
Yeah, the Nationals had a close call there with that 2-on-1, but once again, Hirsch just not able to get that one over, and now here's Chipman. Chipman trying to go inside out here. With Hirsch, not able to do so, Fagan keeps it into the line. Sends it over to Hirsch. Hirsch just backhands it around the net. It'll go back to the blue line. Here's Fisher. He shoots, that one's deflected right on save. Rebound, losing the paint. That one just off the blocker. And a close call again as LeBlanc had a golden scoring opportunity. That one shot on Pat, save London, getting some shots on the net here. And that one's chipped down, and this will go down the ice. Will it make it for icing? No, it won't. Fisher turns on the Jets, and he'll carry it across the neutral zone, makes his way in. He's gonna look in front, trying to find Colton Chipman out in front. Unable to do so, as here's Hirsch. Hirsch back to the point, Atlee Rogers to Fagan. Now, nice little inside out move by Fagan. He's gonna shoot. That one just misses wide. Brandon Scott.
Hey, Hirsch.
Down low to Hirsch. Scott waiting for some traffic. No traffic in front, and that one just blockered up and out of play by O'Donnell, but some beauty work there by the Nationals.
Yeah, the Nationals, good jump in this second period so far now, and look at this play here. Just get a stick on a puck, and look what happens. Three nice chances, but Tommy O'Donnell stands strong and keeps it out of the net.
Well, we always talk about it at length here. When you put the puck towards the net, good things happen. And if the Nationals can generate just a little more traffic, they'll try to find the net more successfully. Puck down inside of London's territory, and now Scott has control. Sends it cross ice, trying to feed McNamara. Haven't seen much of McNamara in this game tonight. Chatham gets in on the play onside, drops it to Brody Gillis. Gillis to Batchick. Batchick shoots, that deflects and goes into the corner. McNamara just can't get the puck off of Gillis. And now it's cross ice here to Cleary. Atlee Rogers goes inside out, trying to maintain control. The puck does so. Tries to go inside out, and once again, Cleary has control. Cleary 1-on-3, basically, as Scott just backhands this over to LePain. LePain just sends it back down low to Brandon Scott. Scott's going to go behind the net and try to get the Nationals to regroup. All three Nationals basically hanging out near the tops of the neutral zone, and now back there is LePain. That one gets chipped down low, and this is going to go for icing. No, it's waved off. Went off a stick, and the Chatham bench not too happy about that one. Is the stick there was not across the red line. Regardless, turnover. Here's Milne. He looks over at Pace Roth, waits. Now hits him. Here's Pace Roth back in towards the middle of the ice. Milne tries to get a shot away, but loses control of the puck. Edward Hickson, he's got a goal on the campaign for the Maroons. He's a call-up here in tonight's game. Nationals get this one out. Maybe a chance here, 2-on-1. Here's Palmer. He's got shooting room. He shoots it. That one stopped. The rebound pops out in front to LePain, and he's unable to collect the loose garbage. Big hit thrown by Kopchuk right at the top of the line, and a retaliation by Matheson. And there's going to be a delayed penalty coming here to Matheson, as he does not like the fact that Kopchuk took a run. Pacerov sends it all the way down the ice, and we are going to see a penalty coming up to the Maroons for that retaliatory hit.
Let's take a look at it here. Puck's going along the wall. Chatham plays it. That's just a nice hit by Kopchuk. And then they're not happy, and he got dumped at the blue line. They're going to call the guy who retaliates every time.
Yep, they always teach these players in today's game to try to keep their head up when they're looking at the puck. That's when that defenseman can get you right in the train tracks, and that's exactly what Kopchuk does. And then Matheson takes the retaliatory penalty.
He's still not happy with the officials here.
So he's off for 2 minutes, and because of the fact that the Nationals had iced the puck, they're going to start the power play down inside their own end. Faceoff won by the Nationals. Kopchuk, they'll just dump this one off, and they couldn't change either, so they have to wait to get their top penalty killers out on the ice. And now Talon Palmer tries to feed Mill, and it goes off the skates, but it does negate the icing. And it'll go all the way back down to Hayden Saber, and that's something else we've seen so far in this game, where just the Nationals forwards have not been clicking. They've been skating in the wrong areas, not finding themselves, trying to create that open space. As Char, he comes in. Dumps it down low to Riley Wood. Cross ice to Palmer. Palmer to Downey. Over the Chard. Puck hops on a little bit. Controls it. Chard going cross ice. Here's a chance. Shot. Scores! Beautiful three-way passing play from high to low. And it's Talon Palmer, Mr. Consistency. He's on the board.
And we said it earlier, Jeremy, that if the Nationals kept getting looks like that on the power play, one of them would find the back of the net. And this one here, Char, nice pass to Palmer. That's just a nice wrister. Finds the back of the net. London's clawing their way back into this game.
They don't ask how, they ask how many. And Talon Palmer gets himself his 14th goal on the campaign. Chatham gonna look to try to respond here as now Josh Harding has control. Puck turned over, chance again for the Nationals. Tried to make the toe drag there, was LeBlanc. And he's unable to do so. Here's Gillis. Gillis taken down on the play. Fagan just chips this one up and down, and icing is negated. Hurt gonna force Harding back. Here's Cal. Kopchuk will send this one up into the neutral zone, where London takes back control and sends this one in deep. And Harding back to retrieve it. Harding sends this one up ice to Cleary. Cleary will try to make the in-and-out move on Fisher. He's unable to do so, as here's Fagan. Tries to make the spin move. Partially gets it done, but it turned over, and here's Cleary, maybe 2-on-1. Cleary ends up stopping up, as here is a chance now for the Maroons. Puck along the sidewall. Nationals trying to get on it. Fagan does. He's going to carry this up ice with Hirsch. Hirsch waits, tries to find a pass option. Elects to try to stick with the cycle. Puck comes outside and goes all the way down the ice. Icing waved off. And here's Brandon Scott. Drops it off here to Rogers. Rogers, nice inside out move. Sends it over to Downey. Downey flips this one in. Trying to hit a stretch pass there. The Maroons will try to get it in deep. There to get it is Burke. Rims it around. Matthew Downey first on it. And he'll just send this one up and out of play. As we approach the midway portion of the second period, Kyle, we're seeing the Nationals slowly build themselves back up here. They're starting to make those passes, and that power play goal showed why.
Yeah, they're just trying to simplify the game a little bit. Get some pucks in areas where you can find a lane to the net. And as you said, that power play was a good example of what they've been doing in the second period.
Nationals win the draw again. Puck turned over, but Brandon Scott right there in the middle of the ice to keep it. And just Chatham will send it right back towards London territory. Here's Chard. Chard cuts towards the middle of the ice. He's got a chance to maybe get a shot away. He's turned over, but a great keep in by Downey. Drops it. Here's Blake Arrowsmith. Arrowsmith feeds Brandon Scott. He's got lots of daylight here. Send it towards the middle of the ice, and that one will clear off. As he was trying to hit Lucas Chart far side. Scott just dumps it back low to Downey. Downey, a bit of pressure. That one's turned over by Henderson. He'll just flip it on to Sabrin, and Sabrin will just drop it right back there to Scott. 3-2 your score. London getting a power play marker here in this second period, courtesy of Talon Palmer. Icing negated as that one. Right on it, there is Chard. Here's Gouvermont. Sends it to Chard. Chard gonna try to cycle this puck up high. Chard spins off the checking, shoots it towards the net. That one's stopped out in front as Gouvermont had fallen down on the play. Centering feed, that one's turned over and now turning on the Jets here. Here's Elson. Elson gets the puck stripped away and here comes Atlee Rogers. Good job keeping it alive. Here's a chance up high. Rogers trying to wrap it around. Loose in front of the net. In the blue paint, and the official blows the whistle as O'Donnell covers it up. And some pushing and shoving in front as Paceroth is getting into the mix.
Yeah, a little bit of heat here now. As Chatham didn't like Paceroth in and around the goalie as that whistle went.
And an interesting note as well just brought up by the truck. That we're 12 minutes into this second period, the Maroons don't have a single shot.
Yeah, that's right. London has really, really put the pressure on Chatham in the second period, showing them we can hang with you guys tonight. Don't let us play our game.
Palmer kicked out of the draw, so now Milne will step in. Wins it cleanly, and Paceroth just unable to control it. Kopchuk sends this one in as LePain just tips it. And now O'Donnell, he's out behind his net. Sends this one up high, but the Nationals get on it first. But good support there by the Maroons as it's rimmed around to the far side. LePain trying to get to the first one there. He is there. And now he's in a bit of a foot race as a good thrown hit by Milne creates some space for Palmer to shoot. As that one's blocked, rebound kicks out to the slot. And a good stretch pass. Here's a chance here for Cloutier. Cloutier inside out, tries to go to the backhand again. He loses man and he ends up making Michael Kopchuk go for a spin. And the puck comes back into the neutral zone. McKay, give and go with his D partner. McKay will just skate this one up. He's got Cleary on this left side and he passes it right to him. Puck down low there as Paceroth is trying to get control. Centering feed, Gillis the shot, and that one stopped there by Sabrin. And that is the first shot on the net for the Maroons here in this second period.
Yeah, that might have looked like an easy save, but with how long Sabrin went without seeing a puck, that save was not as easy as it looked.
Yeah, a little bit of traffic out in front. Good job there of Sabrin just to be square to the shot. Face-off win there by LeBlanc. And now it's sent up by miscommunication a little bit there by the Nationals, but it is sent into the neutral zone, and here's Fisher. Fisher tries to be cute with his pass. Potential break here for the Maroons. Inside out. Shoots that stop there by Savrin. One of his better saves of the evening as Fisher got caught trying to be cute with that pocket of the blue line.
And here is that replay. Here's Fisher just tries to curl back. Doesn't have anything and just kind of gives it right to Chatham. And they walk right in and nice little move there, but Savrin stays strong in the net.
Face off one, and here's PJ Fagan. He's got speed. LeBlanc trying to find Fagan in the middle of the ice, unable to do so. Penalty coming up, and this one's going to go to the Maroons. Chipman centering feed right onto the stick of Burke. And this one is going to go to Burke, and it's going to happen right down low and takes down LeBlanc on the trip.
I think Chatham bench is yelling. They wanted to dive on LeBlanc on that. Not gonna get it, but
you can just see the frustration there on head coach Richard Santos. He, like you mentioned, Kyle, they might have felt that might have been a dive, but not in the referee's eyes. And so London will go to work on the power play. Goes off the glove of Palmer, and now a bit of an interesting scenario here is a. Good opportunity there for the Maroons, shorthanded, as Morante had the puck and was just dog it on it. Chard, he gained the offensive line. He decides to curl up. Loses it, gets back control, waits. Banks it off the back of the net and sends it back to Palmer. Palmer to Downey, Downey waits. Lucas Chard down low. To Downey, Downey. Fakes the shot over to Palmer, Downey, to Chard. Chard gets the shot, Milne was right there. Palmer slap pass, that one, great stick. Again by Morante, as there was Riley Wood with an open cage to shoot at. Chard shoots off the stick of Morante again, and up and out of play. So far on the special teams, you're seeing Morante, number 16 on the Maroons, just being dogged on the puck, almost created a turnover at his own bench. Gets the active stick there, and just really strong penalty kill work.
Really strong penalty kill work, and they need it because London's power play has looked really, really sharp tonight, as we mentioned earlier on the goal in this period. Good puck movement, creating opportunities.
Now second unit out there again, going with the three defensive look, as Fagan is gonna play more of a forward role. Here's Scott Fisher. Scott works his way back towards the middle of the ice, shoots that one, stopped by O'Donnell. Fagan just backhand pass, no one home, didn't look to see where the defense was, and so now London has to regroup. That's one of the other things that London needs to work on as well, is not making that blind pass, as now Fagan, he'll come inside, and he's gonna get called on the offside as makes one too many moves, and the offside is called. Fagan on the campaign, currently at 19 points on the back end. Again, he's a second round pick of this map of the London Knights, 61st overall. And he got some OHL action recently during the World Juniors. London wins control in the top power play unit back out on the ice. Downey, he tried to cut his way in. Does get the puck inside, and now here's Lucas Chard. Chard sends it back to Palmer. Palmer, middle of the ice, over to Milne. Chard, down low shot. Oh, that just missed the net as Hirsch had a chance down low. Back up top, penalty about to expire. Downey waits, shoots, deflects wide, and Downey's without a stick. He's gonna have to go to the bench. Downey does get the stick, and Palmer gets control. He'll shoot from a sharp angle. That one's off of O'Donnell, still down low. Chard, nice in that move, goes towards the slot, and gloved down by O'Donnell.
And as we continue to mention all night, nice passing opportunities by the Nationals, opening up shooting lanes, Wood just missed there on the far side. As O'Donnell dove over if he had to make the save, but Riley Wood, captain, just missed it.
There you see one of the new assistant coaches there on the Nationals bench, Justin Murray. He was playing in the East Coast League and now back here at home in London. He also is a former OHL player, played most of his career with the Barrie Colts and actually captained that Barrie Colts team that had some talent on that team, on the likes of Andrei Svechnikov on that team. You can also say Rasmus Anderson, Andrew Mangiapane. So Justin Murray knows how to play with good talent. He's gonna try to look to see if he can make this Nationals team turn into some good talent. Back down low, here is Harding. Harding's gonna try to skate this one all the way up ice himself. He gets past Hirsch, does gain the offensive blue line. Harding does lose it to Paceroth, and now the Nationals are away with numbers. Hirsch and LeBlanc. Hirsch shoots, that goes up high off the netting. No, it'll stay down. It goes all the way back to the point where Chipman just unable to get there, and now he's gonna be in a foot race with Brody Gillis. Gillis just dog it all over the puck on Chipman. Nationals trying to get to the puck first, but Brody Gillis is there. Chatham gonna try to get the cycle game going. Chipman sends it over to Hirsch. Hirsch waits, trying to send it down low. Good stick by Harding, and now Chatham back the other way. They're here 3-on-2. Drop pass. Unable to get back onto the stick there as the Maroons had a chance to try to get one. Loose out in front, miscommunication. As now Paceroth controls. He'll send it cross ice over to Gouvernement. Gouvernement drops, Atlee Rogers shoots. Toe save made by O'Donnell. Rogers. Good job on the puck protection, trying to win that battle. As there's three Nationals over on that far side. Scratch pass, there's Matheson. Drops it back, Henderson goes off a skate. Henderson back to the point to Jones, he shoots. Easy save made there by Sabrin, rebound. Kicks out there to Matheson. Matheson in the slot loses it, Gouvernement gets control. He'll circle back, trying to find a pass option, finds McNamara.
Oh, no!
Icing negated. Jones. Over to Burke. Burke gains the line, just leaves it for Matheson. Matheson, he cuts back. Waiting for his defense, just ends up starting the cycle game as Henderson has control. Puck at the blue line, turned over again. Matheson just sends it back down low, and here's Brandon Scott. Scott trying to hit Palmer up ice. Is a good stick by the Maroons captain. Bacik, he's gonna step up and join the rush on this play. Shot right on, that goes off Sabrin. Now the Nationals turn to go up ice. Here's LePain. LePain's with Palmer. They're in basically 2-on-4. Check pass on a good job there by Michael Fisher. Is Edwards potentially was gonna be in alone, and just a good active stick by the Nationals D-man. Puck turned over, McNamara sends it up high, shot right on, that misses wide. Puck centered out, and again, trying to dump this one in. Unable to do so, Palmer, he tries to poke check. Puck gets sent down inside of London territory. Fagan. He loses it back, and this is gonna go all the way down the other side of the ice. And now here's McKay. McKay cross ice as we're approaching the final minute of play here in this second period. One goal game in favor of the Maroons. Edwards drops it to McKay. There is traffic in front. That one shot, that's deflected into the slot. And now Blake Arrowsmith has it. Maybe one more chance for the Nationals as they come in with speed. Arrowsmith, he toe drags, shot, loose in front, and gets a second opportunity, whacks at it. Unable to get it there. There, back below behind the net is Cloutier. Chatham just gonna send this all the way down the length of the ice. Fisher tries to make a play on it, and icing is gonna be called, so a close chance there for the Nationals as they had showed some speed there on that rush.
Take a look at that last rush here. Nice individual effort by Arrowsmith, toe drags around a man. Gets in the middle, gets two chances, one pops up into the middle, O'Donnell didn't see it, but it did not bounce back onto the stick for another chance.
27 seconds left. Faceoff won there by the Maroons. Wood trying to be the first one on it. Chatham tries to exit the zone. Aerosmith gets control. This one out, and look at big hit thrown there by Downey. As again, Maroons don't like that one. And one more chance with a couple seconds left. Here's Lucas Chard. Chard cuts it. He scores! A buzzer beater! Chard's second of the night, and with 1.6 left in the period, it is tied at 3. And the Chatham bench is not happy about the hit.
Nice heads up play though by Chard to recognize the plate coming back the other way. Waited at the blue line, collected the puck, went in alone. Nice little backhand, beat O'Donnell. We're tied with 1.6 seconds left here in the second. And there you see Richard Santos not happy at all with that hit, as you mentioned.
Yeah, you can see there is Elson, Rory Elson's over there to have a chat there with the referee as Downey came in up at the middle of the ice, threw the hit, and they weren't happy about it, trying to get a call, but none going. As we await for one more forward, they're just going to drop this puck as Matheson and Aerosmith collect together.
A little bit of heat,
and we got a bit here, and the gloves have come off. Matheson and Aerosmith. Aerosmith keeps the gloves on, but the gloves have come off. And a second period here. Now the helmet's off of Matheson. He's still trying to get some shots in towards Aerosmith. Still going at it here. Trying to break them up as again they're going at it. And they finally break up as Madeline just throws his helmet towards the one and bench, throws the gloves. And a bit of excitement here as the second period comes to a close. Aerosmith has lost his bucket.
And here, let's take a look at the start of this. Aerosmith and Matheson just sticking each other in the back of the leg. And Aerosmith might have said something to Matheson, and then it was on. And we got some jawing going on actually at the benches too, Jerry. Santos is not at all happy with the coaching staff of the London Nationals.
Yes, Brian McAllister said a few words towards Santos as well, as still both sides have yet to leave the ice. The period's well over, but we are just waiting for the teams to leave, and I believe the referees are saying to the Nationals to go to the room. They want them to leave first. And you can see McAllister just down there right near the officials. And the officials are just telling both teams just to get off and go to the rooms. As still some choice words are being said by this Maroons coaching staff. We've seen some heat here before, but we haven't seen heat like this so far this season.
No, and this could be a factor in the third period. The refs are gonna have to play this one really carefully to avoid further shenanigans.
And the same can be said for both of the coaching staffs as well. They just need to get their players to the rooms. And both coaches are still on their benches as Santos is still showing his frustration as he finally leaves. And McAllister shows his frustration as well. So what a way to end the second period. We'll be back with some second intermission thoughts. You're watching Archon Aggregates Nationals Hockey here on Rogers TV.
Welcome back. I'm joined with Riley Wood, captain of the London Nationals. Now, Riley, as the captain, what are you hoping to see from your team as we're heading into the later half of the season?
Later half of the season, we're really looking to finish games out, play a full 60 minutes, and really see what type of character this team has.
You're on an 8-game point streak. You've extended that here tonight. What do you think the key to your personal success has been?
I think I play with some great line mates who know my game well, and we really have good chemistry.
You're a leader and role model on this team. Who has been a role model for you throughout your hockey career?
I've really played with a bunch of different great leaders and teammates over the years, but I think Burridge was really a really good leader for the team, but I think he has the biggest impact on me.
A strong second period has led to a tie game. What are you and your teammates looking to do to complete the comeback here tonight?
I think we just got to be strong on pucks and win the puck battles at the blue lines, and we'll be all right.
Thank you so much, Riley. We'll be right back with some more London Nationals hockey here on Rogers TV after this.
Game Day London takes readers behind the scenes and beyond the box scores, offering news, analysis, long form and interviews, all produced by local journalists. Catch the coverage at GameDayLondon.com. Well, that was an interesting second period. We had some shenanigans at the end, Kyle, but let's start with the goal scoring. The Nationals get on the power play, get themselves a goal, then make it back to within one, and midway through, Chatham didn't have a shot on the net. So talk to me about how London was able to get themselves on the board there in that second period.
Yeah, I think they just stuck to their game plan, just use their speed to their advantage, and it showed here. Two really nice goals. Three-way passing play on the power play. Kalen Palmer with the tally, and that puts some life in this London Nationals team. There you see right at the end of the period, Chard racing in to beat the buzzer and tie the top.
Yeah, 1.6 seconds left on that marker. Like we mentioned, a power play marker for Palmer there earlier on. as Downey and Chard get the assists, and then Lucas Chard with that buzzer beater goal with 1.6 seconds to go. And again, the goaltending in this matchup for Sabrin didn't really see much action there in period number two, but the same could be said as well for O'Donnell, as he was a busy netminder.
Yeah, complete polar opposites really here. O'Donnell seen 30 shots as opposed to the half of that 14 that Sabrin seen. And in that second period especially, I thought Sabrin did a really good job because he didn't see a shot for 12 minutes in that period.
Yeah, we mentioned all of that rough stuff and shenanigans there at the end of that second period. We're going to take a look at what originally started all of that. And it started there with Aerosmith taking that shot there. Weren't happy about that. And then Downey as well. And that's the shot there from Downey was the one that set the Chatham coaching staff off. And then Aerosmith and Matheson. Matheson breaks Aerosmith's stick. And then they drop their sticks and they start the wrestling match. I know we've got Hammerlock Pure Wrestling here on Rogers TV. That's pretty close to it. And both coaching staffs were not happy with each other about how that went. And that all basically started with Chatham not being happy about those two hits.
No, it's not. And I think that you're going to see a bleed over of that into the third period. The refs are going to have to watch because this thing could get out of hand really quickly if they don't call this game a little tighter.
Yeah, you can see there Santos on the side of the Maroons, and then also the head coach of the Nationals as well, McAllister. They were going back and forth, jawing words. And again, just interesting to see how this third period is going to be played out here again with the Nationals. I think out of all of that, you might see the Nationals go on to a power play. But again, going to be interesting to see as we close out this third period. And heading into this third period, what do you think the Nationals need to do? Already now tied. What do they need to do to get to this next period and try to win?
I think they just need a repeat of that second period because that was a almost perfect period for the Nationals. Only gave up a handful of shots. They gave up six in that period, putting a lot of sticks in passing lanes in that second period, doing a lot of things right and generating chances on the other end.
Well, we had shenanigans at the end of the second. We'll see if there's going to be any more in the third period. You're watching Archon Aggregates Nationals Hockey here on Rogers TV. Our next contest here on Rogers TV will be next Wednesday here at 7 p.m. The number two seed at the moment, LaSalle Vipers, will be here for a rare Wednesday night matchup between the two teams, as LaSalle normally plays their home games on Wednesday nights as well. As we're going to go back to that buzzer-beating goal here by Lucas Char, just being able to come right in, cut across, find the back of the net with 1.6 seconds left.
Yeah, really nice heads-up play by him to see the, notice the play coming the other way and just wait at that blue line to collect that puck and race in to beat the buzzer here and tie us up heading into the third.
And yeah, so what's going to happen here is you're going to have both referees are over at the respective benches to give the penalties on the play. So out of all of that, we received it during the intermission. So Blake Arrowsmith, he got a 2-minute instigator penalty, a 5-minute major for fighting, comes with the automatic game misconduct. He also gets a helmet removal penalty. And then the same can be said for Noah Matheson as well as the Chatham Maroons. So he'll get a 2-minute instigator, 5 minutes for fighting, plus a game misconduct, plus a helmet removal. So both teams going to be down a player for the rest of this game, and suspensions are going to likely be coming out of that. And you can still see there as Richard Santos is not quite fuming now, just trying to explain his case as to what he feels should be the case for his team.
Yeah, he's not fuming, but by the body language, he is still an unhappy man behind that bench.
And so now just the officials just getting themselves settled here as the off-ice officials are just making sure that all the penalties are correct and that they've got everything on the board correctly as well. So out of all of that, we still are going to remain 5-on-5. And with this being tied here at 3, both teams are going to want to make sure that they keep their heads cool, knowing that two key points are on the line here to close out this third period.
And with only 18 games left in the regular season, every point matters.
All right, we are all situated here. Third period about to get started. And the puck is dropped and the Nationals lose control of the draw and it's sent in deep to Sabourin. Sabourin just dumps that one off to Downey. Downey there to Hirsch. Pardon me, Riley Wood is blows a tire. Here comes Chard in. Chard pass off, just misses off the stick of Milne. Milne was just unable to collect that puck and bury that one. Close call for the Nationals early. Cut inside out and gobbled up there by O'Donnell as Riley Wood made a nice couple of moves.
Yeah, Riley Wood, nice couple of moves here. And you see, you're going to see here, Chard takes opportunity of that blown tire and he just uses his speed, gets into the faceoff circle, and then tries to get the puck across crease, but just couldn't find the stick.
Yeah, now you're gonna see the lines juggled now with Arrowsmith removed from this game. So now you're seeing Milne move up to that top line. So now the Nationals are down to 11 forwards.
And that's a tough loss to take too, because Arrowsmith has 10 goals on the season in just 20 games.
Well, it's also just interesting that Milne normally plays with Lucas Chard out here on this top line. They had moved Arrowsmith up to it, so ideally this is actually London's official top line. Chatham has control, they'll try to dump it in. It's in the skates of Elson and dumped over to Edwards. Elson tried to gain back control, kept in at the line. That one shot off a stick. Downey gonna go over to the sidewall, collect it, and shoot this one down. Off a stick, kept inside. Here's Wood. Wood trying to drop it to Milne. Penalty coming up. And this one is going to go, I believe, to the Maroons. And hooking is the call, and London will go to the power play.
Take a look at this penalty again here. as Wood tries to cut through to the side, and there, stick gets wrapped around, he falls down. There's your hooking call.
Yeah, a little bit of a high hook towards Wood. Face off won by the Maroons. Palmer will keep it in at the blue line. Over to Downey. Charge. Back to Downey, feeds Palmer. Palmer walking in. Back to Downey to Charge. The one-time shot is blocked. Charge gets control back. Dumps it to Wood. Downey to Charge. They'll play pitch and catch. Swing it down low to Wood. Creeping in, Palmer shoots. That one goes well wide. And still behind the Chatham net. Wood. He just gets bowled over there by Badgett. Downey shoots that one fast stop. Palmer collects. Milne, he's hanging around in front. Palmer, he shoots, Pat saves, rebound, couple of whacks at it. And Bacik's there and Milne's there. And some more pushing and shoving here as the Chad Maroons are not allowing the Nationals to get any extra whacks towards the netminder in O'Donnell.
No, but this is a really nice play though. Palmer just shoots Milne right in front for the rebound, takes another whack, and then that's when the shenanigans start again. So another good look on a power play for the London Nationals here.
Yeah, faceoff's gonna come outside just because of the fact you've got the defenseman stepping in towards that scrum. Still a minute to go here in the Nationals power play. They've scored one on the night. And that was courtesy of Talon Palmer. And Lucas Chard has a three-point night in here so far tonight with a goal, with two goals and an assist. Fisher tried to drop that down low. PJ Fagan's gonna have to go in and come after this puck. Battle along the sidewall. Fisher gonna try to keep it in. He does attempt to do so and does it successfully. Puck's in the feet of PJ Fagan, and Atlee Rogers is there as well. Not much room to try to create a pass, but they get it down low. Hirsch, back to Fagan. Fagan just bounces off of his stick, and a penalty coming to the Nationals, and it's gonna go to Jermey Hirsch. As just a sloppy play there by Fagan leads to a negated power play. Now it's a 4-on-4.
Yeah, Fagan turns his puck over right in their end. And just sloppy play turns into a penalty there for the Nationals. And now we're going to play 4-on-4 for 17 seconds.
So now Chatham will send most of their power play unit out here, being 4-on-4 to start. Pace off won by the Nationals. Pace off down low. Bouncing puck, and he'll just send this one outside the zone. And here's Batchik, captain. He'll work his way, trying to make a stretch pass, doesn't work, and now the Nationals have it. May have maybe a chance shorthanded, but a good job there as Jones comes out of the box. And he'll touch this puck behind the net and carry it up. Comes in with some speed and plays the dump and chase. Pace Rock, he's just trying to pin this puck. Three Maroons, two Nationals. Puck comes towards the front of the net. Good active stick there by LePain. Centering feet into the slot. Works its way down low. Good active stick. Still loose in the slot. Comes back up to the point. Burke. That one's blocked and it'll clear the zone. And now the Nationals will just wait as Chipman has it, floats it high up in the air. Chance for LePain to go after it, and he'll just stop up right out in front of O'Donnell, and O'Donnell will hang on with 49 seconds to go here in Chatham's power play.
Yeah, London had doing a very good job on this penalty kill. Not putting, getting sticks in lanes, making sure Chatham doesn't have any easy looks on Sabourin.
And one of the linesmen picking up a neck guard that Dallin handed it off to the London bench. Yeah, actually, I had given it to Frogovic. It turns out it's actually one of the players on the Maroons that has it. And it's actually Jones, so he has to come off the ice because it was his neck guard. And so stepping onto the ice will be Tyler McGuire to replace Jones on that play. Chatham wins it, but Milne trying to be the first one there, throws the hit behind the net. And now back there to get it. Now is coming in with speed here is Aiden Edwards. Edwards. In a battle there with Brandon Scott. Dallin Palmer is going to be there in a foot race with McGuire. To Cleary. Edwards comes in. He'll just put it down low, trying to work it way back to the point. Dallin Palmer gets control. He's going to try to spin fire this puck out. And now he'll just look to pin. That one shot up into the air and cleared out there by Matthew Downey. And a clear. Tyler McGuire. Here to Colton Henderson, who has one of the Chatham goals tonight. He makes a nice move on Fagan. But charged back defensively, just does a good job of just getting his stick in the lane. And now maybe the Nationals have a chance, maybe abbreviated 2-on-1. Chart over to Wood. Wood just can't get his stick on it. And back and forth we go as here's Burke. He's got Cloutier on the far side. That goes off the skate of Fagan. Good save made there by Sabrin. Chard. Nice feed over. Across the ice to Palmer. Chard. He's got PJ Fagan in the high slot. Tries to go inside out there on Burke, and Burke will just send it into the neutral zone. Brody Gillis involved. Puck sent here towards the near boards. Fortier Smith. Works his way up ice. That's dumped in. Here comes Sabrin way out of the net. Bill Gillis is there, and a save made by Sabrin. We've seen that type of goaltending from Carter Froggett. But now it's Hayden Sabrin's turn to be a little bit risky.
And we saw Sabrin get a little aggressive earlier in the game playing a puck. This one almost had the same result as you see here. Way out of the net, takes a bounce off the Chatham player. Luckily for Sabrin, he shot it right at the pad. So he didn't have a repeat of the first period.
Yeah, caught a lucky break as on that turnover on the first one. That was Brody Gillis, who got a goal for Chatham and almost had his second of the night. It's down low, here's Morante. Morante sends it up high here to Kalp. Kalp sends it out, and the Nationals will get the clear. Austin Gouvernement hard here on Harding. London making changes. Rogers tries to throw the hit. Unable to do so, and that's just dumped in deep. PJ Fagan back there. Just lets the puck slide by him. The Nationals try to clear the line, stays inside. Kopchak, he's in a puck battle, comes to the line. That one doesn't clear. Walking right in, that one's blocked by Gouvernement. Gets the body in front. Atlee Rogers just dumps it over to Kopchak. Nationals trying to get a change. They'll rim it around, and here's Gouvernement. Gouvernement gives control. Here's Rogers. He's got McNamara with him. Just floats it towards goal, and it's blockered away. And O'Donnell's going to get the glove down, and he'll get a faceoff to his right with some fresh forwards coming out on the ice for both teams.
$40 is a blue ticket. Blue ticket number 473-003.
12:43 to go, a 3-3 tie. Nationals win the draw, right to the paint shot. That's just a pat save made there by O'Donnell. O'Donnell has lost his goal stick. And that one is sent out of play and into the Chatham bench. So O'Donnell can go get his stick.
Interesting thing to keep a note on again, as you mentioned in that second period. Chatham got their first shot 8 minutes in. We are 12 minutes into the period. We're 8 minutes in here. Chatham still only one shot in this period.
And London just doing a good job of just keeping possession of the puck and not allowing anything towards Hayden Sabrin. that one shot would be the one from Brody Gillis off the turnover. But Payne, he tries to get involved, as now here's Jones. Long ice pass, and this is going to go for icing. As you can start to see, Chatham's trying to open the ice up a little bit more here, Kyle. Trying to make those types of stretch passes, trying to catch the Nationals off guard.
Yeah, they are trying to catch them off guard. A lot more cross ice and a lot more Hail Mary type passes here the third period. Trying to just get that one break to maybe open this game up a little bit.
Yeah, it's also interesting to note that over the next 2 weeks, the Nationals will play six games in a span of 11 days, as the Nationals are actually going to go to Sarnia, down to Sarnia, and play the Legionnaires tomorrow, and then they'll play a road game on Saturday as well, and then they'll be back here at the Western Fair next Wednesday. We'll have that game for you here on Rogers TV. LaSalle Vipers will be here. Good active stick by Chart. It's in his skates. Tries to feed Riley Wood as Wood couldn't get control, and he just sends it down low. Here's Milne. Milne to Wood, slap shot. That one's blocked. Henderson caught with a high stick, and penalty upcoming to the Nationals. Still not touched. Now it gets touched. And so a high stick is going to be called, and this one's going to go to Milne. And so now the Maroons get a power play.
Yeah, just kind of one of those ones where you need to have better control in your stick, as Millen was trying to play the puck but missed badly and got him right in the face.
Yeah, and you can just see there, Henderson down, felt the blade of his stick going up under into the neck area. And so now Chatham gets another opportunity, their fourth here of the contest. They win the draw. Burke, slap shot. That one's stopped. Is that up in the air? Fagan tries to clear it, lands right onto Burke's stick. Fagan throws his man down. Burke sends it up top. He gets it right back. Over there, Batchett sends it down low, trying to feed a man in the slot. Unable to do so, and he'll come all the way out to Brody Gillis. Gillis on the campaign has 13 points, as now he's up to 5 goals and 8 assists on the campaign. And like I mentioned earlier on, he started the season here with the Nationals before being sent to the Maroons. Cloutier. Shoulder fakes, just drops it back to Gillis. Gillis has Talon Palmer all over him as Kopchuk's down low. So is Pace Roth, to defense. Down low, the Nationals need to make sure they have someone out in front. Wraparound chance, that one stopped, and the net has come off its moorings. And so we'll have a faceoff just to the right of Hayden Sabre.
And Chatham on this power play doing exactly what we just mentioned, trying to open up the game a little bit, get a lot more opportunities here. Sabre's had to be sharp here in the last minute 10 on the London penalty kill.
First, trying to win the draw, loses it. Now the second unit out here for the Maroons. Battle down low between Kopchuk and Henderson. Henderson okay after taking the high stick. And Jermey Hirsch will just send that one down right onto O'Donnell. And now Graydon Jones will pick the puck up. 30 seconds to go here in the Chatham power play. Puck sent right down low, Pace Roth. Look out into the London bench. As Pace Roth just wound up and fired, and that almost hit Brian McAllister there as well.
You see the guy smiling there. LeBlanc actually fell over trying to get out of the way of that, but gonna have a good laugh now that nobody got hit.
Yeah, and then the man to the left there of McAllister, some London Knights fans might know as Rob Drummond, part of that team of the century in 2004-2005. Good to see him on the bench. He is a part of the London Junior Knights organization as well, being a coach in that group. As that puck is sent all the way down the ice for icing. And so this revamped Nationals coaching staff has experience with McAllister and Drummond, both coming from the Junior Knights organization. And then the same can be said as well as from Justin Murray, being a London, Ontario kid. Murray and Drummond making the OHL, Murray being a captain. Puck won by the Nationals and Nysing being negated as Downey has control. He has a man on him already as here's Wood. Wood stretch pass over to Milne, not able to land it on his stick. Downey once again, Henderson all over him as here's Wood. Soft pass to Charge. Charge gonna carry this one in. He'll lose it in his feet and Brandon Scott picks it up. Scott just spins and passes it back over. Dumped in, here's Chard, maybe a chance here. Chard busts in, he loses it, and a good block there down low as the Maroons just take away any type of passing play from Lucas Chard. Fisher steps up, allows Wood to get the puck as he gets rubbed out. And now Chatham regroups here with Josh Harding, newly acquired Josh Harding. As again, the GOJHL trade deadline passed at 7 o'clock p.m. and so no more moves can be made. And now Chatham has a backhand shot. That goes right on to Hayden Sabrin and he'll hang on. And so a few transactions, the Maroons, they trade Brendan Gouin to the LaSalle Vipers. Aiden Hill, he got released to junior C to the Wheatley Sharks. Aiden McKinley and Cameron Robinson, both defense, they were also both released to the Blenheim Blades. So the Maroons loading up, trying to make themselves a run here as the Nationals have control with Palmer. Puck goes into the middle of the slot. Fisher gonna have to hurry back as here comes three Maroons busting in, shot, and that goes right into the glove of Hayden Sabrin, reading that one all the way. Not many changes for the Nationals when it comes to the trade deadline. They actually released Nolan Miller. He goes to the Temford Trojans of the PJHL, and a player we have not seen yet in the lineup. He was a scratch tonight, but he's played two games so far as William Poot. He came from Mississauga in the OJHL. That's here's a shot, that goes high and wide. Puck kept in by Bacik. Hooks his way here to the near corner boards. Kopchak trying to win that foot race, loses it to Fortier Smith. Hooks his way back to the point, Gillis loses it, now a foot race for the puck, and Gillis trying to regain control, lands onto the stick of Palmer. Once again, Fortier Smith for the Maroons. Puts it towards net, that one's blocked as here's Chipman. Chipman gonna send this over to Palmer, maybe a two on one late. Sends it through and Palmer just not able to get it. Pardon me, Paceroth was sneaking in down low. Chipman tried to make a centering feed. LePaint sending it across. London gonna make some changes. Cloutier, he loses control. Paceroth, nice inside out move as he's got the puck. Logan Paceroth tries a shot, that one's blocked. And now back to retrieve it now is Graydon Jones. Jones to Elson. Elson just dumps this one in deep. Jeremy Hirsch back there as well as LeBlanc. LeBlanc trying to get some speed going, but good offensive pressure there by the Maroons to keep the puck in. Shot from down low. That'll go as a shot. One-time option. That one misses wide. Back to the point here, Elson. Elson just sends that one back down low, trying to man a man in the slot. Loose puck in the slot. And Sabrin just has to use stick that one away. Matthew Downey. He sends this up ice to LePaint, trying to send a soft pass to Hirsch. Hirsch, he's in, trying to cut across the middle. Still loose in the slot. Back to Brandon Scott. He shoots. That one bounces down low. And the whistle is blown as O'Donnell covers up as a flurry in front of the Chatham net once again.
Yeah, flurry in front of the chatter net, but a weird play on the other end here. As look at the shot, hits a skate. Sabrin has to be quick to react and poke it away. And here comes the other way. And that's a nice save by Tommy O'Donnell. He's seen numerous times tonight.
Puck shot on block, and now Brandon Scott back to retrieve it. Puck sent over here to Wood. Top line again out here for the Nationals, trying to get themselves another goal here as we're still tied at three with 5 minutes and 50 seconds left here to go. Here's Wood. Sends it over to Milne. Milne, line pass, doesn't work. Onto the stick now of Warner. Scott back to Downey. Nationals gain control and they'll just send it softly in. Bouncing puck lands right into the middle of the ice. But now again, Warner gets control. And that one's gonna be called for icing. As the Maroons not able to just chip that one over that red line. And so another offensive draw coming. Here is again, Santos not happy with that play.
And out of town score update pertains to this game, LaSalle tied with St. Mary's right now.
Yeah, that game has big implications. If St. Mary's wins, they create a little bit of separation. Because currently they lead both London and LaSalle by a point. Fagan over to Fisher. Fisher trying to look for an alternate option to Chard. And Chard does get control. Chard being surrounded by a couple of Maroons players as now Harding has control. Atlee Rogers tries to keep that puck in. Now coming in to dump the puck in, there is Brendan Burke, or pardon me, Braden Burke. And now Fagan. Waits for the setup. Nationals sending two players up high at the blue line. As Palmer tries to touch it and he won't get it. Icing will be called against the Nationals and a faceoff will come all the way down into the territory of Hayden Sabourin.
And late in the game, clock's ticking away. This is a very important faceoff here for the Nationals to win.
Yeah, both teams would love to get out of here with a regulation win. For Chase Smith, he shoots right on. That one stopped. Palmer there to take the chance away from Gillis. Gillis works his way here with Cleary. Now the Nationals try to come out here with numbers. Here's Chipman. He might be in a foot race. Chipman's going to be first on it. Sends it across, off a skate, loose in front, rebound, scores! It's Atlee Rogers! He's on the board, the Nationals have that lead. It's 4-3, 4 minutes to go.
What do we always say? Put pucks on the net, good things will happen. And for Atlee Rogers, that's number 7. And here we see nice breakout by the Nationals. Chipman using his speed to win the puck battle. And Rogers just scoops that and hits the top corner.
A bit of an unlucky break as it goes off the skate of Fortier Smith, off the pads of O'Donnell, and Atlee Rogers just right place, right time, goes towards the middle of the net and just buries it on the backhand. London now leads by one. Paceroth sends it over here to LePain. LePain. Does he get it out? Yes, and so now Chatham will have to touch up. Hirsch has control, just backhands that one out and gets the clear. Nationals not want to be too aggressive now. You've got the one goal lead, need to just continue the possession game. Chatham dumps this puck in. Sabourin leaves it to Kopchuk. Kopchuk just backhands it off to Hirsch. Hirsch, he gets it out, comes in. Here's LeBlanc, they stay onside. And trying to feed it over to LePain. Good hit thrown there by the Maroons as London just gonna try to keep possession and keep this puck inside. Here's Hirsch. He shoots, that one goes off a stick and up and out of play. And so faceoff is gonna stay inside of London territory. And with 3 minutes to go, we'll see at some point whether or not the Maroons elect to call their timeout. I don't think we'll see it happen now, but if it, another whistle inside 2 minutes or so, you'll see it. You can just see right now, Santos has all of his Maroons players over at the bench right now. They're drawing up an offensive scheme already for the players that will be coming on the ice in the final 2 minutes. Puck sent down the ice, icing negated. Brandon Scott goes behind his net, gonna try to get this one out, does not. He gets a second chance, dumps this one off to Lucas Chard. Chard already 3 points on the night. Carries this one in. Here's Milne. Milne just dumps this one in. Chard's going to get first on it. He'll try to pin this puck now. Riley Wood. Wood is doing a good job of protecting the puck, not just wanting to throw it away here. Chard. He does a good job of protecting. Inside out move. Puts it towards the net. He's still got control. Great work here by Lucas Chard. Chard now to Wood. They're just pinning this puck. Here's Chard. Just floats it towards the net. Lands on the stick of Riley Wood. He's going to jam away at it. And the referee's whistle blows as I believe the net has come off its moorings. Yes, it has. And so we will see a faceoff stay inside of Chatham territory.
Yeah, see, we will. And you mentioned it here, Jermey. London playing really good keep away here, just trying to kill some time and get their 2 points.
Yeah, it's a great athletic play there by Riley Wood, just to control the puck, knock it down, and try to put it toward goal. Chatham wins control, and they send three right away. Cloutier comes across. Now Palmer loops it towards the empty net, and he just misses, as O'Donnell had come out to leave for the empty net. And now likely going towards the net. Yes, he is. So the Maroons are likely going to go 6-on-5 here. Interesting that they have yet to call their timeout, so they're going to try to hold on to it and hope for another whistle. Fortier Smith. Down low to Gillis. Gillis down low, as now they jam away at it. Scott and Downey down there. Shut down pair. Rogers, he steps in. Here's Downey. He's got an open net to shoot at. Just puts it down low. Icing is going to be negated. Chipman is just going to pin this puck again. The Nationals just not wanting to throw any puck away here. Just going to try to maintain possession. Here come the Maroons up ice. Here's Cleary. Cleary's going to dump this one in on Downey. Downey takes his man down hard, and that's a penalty. Gillis comes in hard, and we've got another scramble. The original penalty is going to go to Downey for the hit. We'll see what else comes out of this here, as I believe that's going to be the only penalty that we see out of this, as Downey's going to go likely for roughing or boarding here.
In this situation in the game, Jermey, I think this is one you can't take, because he's in a vulnerable position there, and then he just kind of gives him a little forearm shiver, and down he went. That was not a nice-looking play. Luckily, though, Cleary does get up and seems to be fine.
Yeah, just a bit of an interesting scenario there, as Cleary might have also lost an edge.
And we still got some jawing here before the faceoff.
Yeah, you can just see there's a shot there thrown. There is Chipman's in the mix.
That was Vasek taking him down.
And Vasek motioning towards the London bench, saying, what do you want? And so the faceoff out of all of this is going to come outside once again because of the fact that defensemen came down behind the goal line for the scrum. And so a power play coming up here for the Maroons. And now they've taken their timeout. So a timeout has been called here by the Maroons. Minute 19 left here in the game. And at this point, if you're the Maroons, you're putting everything towards the net. And the Nationals have to be aware of that and just try to close down and not allow any type of loose change. You can just see from the lips there of Brian McAllister as he's telling his troops to just keep everything to the outside and not allow any type of bumper play to happen. And then on the other side of the ice, you can see Richard Santos. He's drawing up the scheme to try to get some quick puck movement and try to get one towards Hayden Sabrin. The key thing here too, Kyle, is that this faceoff, like we just mentioned, is going to start outside. So if the Nationals can win this puck, they can just shoot this down and not have to worry about any real threat of icing. Fagan has control. He gets it out, sends it down. Here's Milne, he's trying to get at the puck. He's taken down, and now here come the Maroons. Gillis, already a goal in this game. Waits, loses control, but does maintain it. And it's sent down low. Sent all the way down the ice towards the net, and it will miss. Now with 50 seconds left, Bacik. Stretch pass, London not wanting to be too aggressive here. Gillis being harassed by Milne. Lucas Chard, he's gonna try to get to the puck first. He can't get it. Now it's onto a stick of a Maroon. Fagan will clear this one down the ice. 30 seconds left here in the third period. Chatham gonna wanna get this puck up ice quick. Bacik, he has to stop off control. Puck is sent in deep. Fagan gonna be in a foot race here with Morante. Morante, that clears the zone. 15 seconds left. One more chance here for the Maroons. Bacik trying to send it in deep. There's a bit of a scramble in the middle. Trying to drive wide, trying to center the puck. Loose out in front, scramble behind the net. Sabourin down behind the net. Fisher's controlled. Game over. And the Nationals survive a comeback, being down by two goals. They are able to get this one back, get the 2 points, and currently, as we sit, have a potential first place lead at the moment. You're watching Archon Aggregates Nationals Hockey here on Rogers TV. We will have post-game thoughts right after this. Did you know all the camera operators for tonight's game are volunteers? Rogers TV volunteers learn the skills needed to put on a show, including camera, audio, graphics, and more. If you're interested, visit rogerstv.com/volunteer to sign up. What a comeback here for the Nationals, down 3-1 heading into the second intermission, being tied at 3. The Nationals able to get one goal here in this third period, being the game winner for the Nationals, and it's Atlee Rogers that gets that game winner.
Yeah, and it's another example of just put pucks on net and good things will come your way, and that's just what the Nationals did. As Chipman wins that battle, they just kind of throw it on net. It takes an unfortunate bounce. Atlee Rogers in the right place at the right time to get the game-winning goal.
Guessing for Rogers, he's able to capitalize on that one. His seventh on the campaign from Palmer and Chipman. Shots on goal for this game ended up being 41-22. So the Nationals almost double up on this Chatham squad. And so currently as we sit, the Nationals are in first place. But with that game down on LaSalle, that game actually now is in overtime. And if St. Mary's wins, they'll maintain first place. But if they don't, and if the game actually remains potentially in, and if LaSalle wins, you'll have three teams in a tie potentially for first place. So that game just wrapped up. And so now three teams now tied for top spot here in the Western Conference. So overall, Kyle, what are your final thoughts here on this game here tonight?
Yeah, I thought it was a really good response by the Nationals in the second and third after going down early 3-1. Played really nice hockey, just got sticks in lanes, so Chatham had nothing easy to see. And as a result, they were held off the score sheet the rest of the game.
Indeed, they are. Nationals will travel down to Sarnia tomorrow night. Sophie will send it down to you for 3 stars. Sophie?
Thanks, guys. Well, a strong second and third period performance was the key to the Nationals' success here tonight as they beat the Chatham Maroons 4-3. And now for our 3 stars. The third star tonight is tonight's game-winning goal scorer, Atlee Rogers. The second star is Chatham Maroons forward Jacob Cloche as he scored a goal. And the first star is London Nationals forward Lucas Chard. He scored 2 goals and picked up an assist in tonight's contest. Tune in next Wednesday, January 17th, to see the Nationals take on the LaSalle Vipers in what should be an exciting game. The broadcast will start at 7 p.m. with puck drop just shortly after. On behalf of myself, Kyle, Jeremy, and the crew, thank you so much for watching London Nationals Hockey here on Rogers TV.